Hello and welcome to Sports Gaming Universe channel here on YouTube, and we've got more NHL 17 information for you today in the way of another trailer. Gonna break this thing down. This is featuring EASHL improvements. Yeah, the EA Sports Hockey League has always been a fun mode since it was introduced. A great way to get people together, form a team, and get out there and be able to play up to 6-on-6. Which is really sweet in any sport video game, but it has worked really well, in my opinion, here over its life in the NHL series. Now they're bringing even more to it this year. You can have a lot of customization going on that's not going to be fully in your hands from the start. You're going to have to earn it by unlocking as you go along. Those things include uniform elements, logo elements, and most noticeably, it's going to include your stadium elements, which you're going to start from just a local community rink and build all the way up to an NHL size arena, which, by the way, you can customize, which is pretty sweet. You're seeing a lot of that right here, from the look and feel of it to your goal songs. So customization, the name of the game this year. Also, they're talking about 4 new player classes this year, 18 in total. So just even more customization on how you like to play the game and what kind of a style player you want to be. There's going to be badges that are going to unlock things here, just like goal celebrations and a lot of the stuff that's going on in your arena. So it's all looking really sweet. I kind of regretted the fact that in NHL 16 I really did not get into much EASHL. I think we started off just a little bit at the start and it really tailed off for me because it is something I enjoy doing. I want to have a community team. I want to have a Sports Gaming Universe team this year, especially with all this customization. I think it would be a great live stream series where we can have people who are in the live stream jump in and be a part of the SGU EASHL team, and we can run games and kind of talk about it as we go, highlighting those in live streams. I think that'd be a lot of fun. I think it'll be a lot of fun to track all the progression as far as what we unlock and kind of building the whole brand of our club and being able to take our arena to the next level, take our uniforms to the next level. I think it'd be a lot of fun to just kind of chronicle that as we go. So I'm looking forward to that personally on Sports Gaming Universe and being able to build that up. I want you guys to hold me to it that we do take to the ice a lot in EASHL. We'll have videos on joining as soon as we get the game underway, when we get the game in our hands and are able to do so. We'll have a video detailing all the ways to get in and join that team. So that'll be in the future, obviously, when NHL 17 actually drops. But for now, getting a glimpse of what EASHL is going to look like. We've been told about the customization, both in this and in franchise mode, how a lot of that's going to piggyback each other. One thing I guess I know looking from this and just kind of knowing how NHL operates is I don't believe they allow for importing actual logos of your own yet. That's something that 2K does for basketball in their Pro-Am, and it was pretty cool to be able to put my SGU logo in and put it on the court and put it on the uniform. So I'd very much like to see that in the future of the NHL series, as well as games like MLB The Show. They don't have it yet either. So I think that's kind of the next level when it comes to customization here, is maybe even have it be an unlock at a certain point. You reach a certain level and you're able to import your own graphics. So I realize you can do quite a bit from the ones that are in the game, and you can do endless color schemes and customization as far as what style of jersey, all the piping and the lettering that you can do, but it would be very nice to introduce that option to have your own logos in there. I would love to throw the SGU logo on the jerseys and go to battle in that way. I think that'd be really sweet. Anyway, there'll be enough to do in the way of customization to make our team unique, and that'll be no problem. We'll be able to deal with what's in here. I'm just looking as a wish list feature that I've wanted for a while there, to be able to import our own logos. So overall, I'm liking what I'm seeing. Obviously, more options and more customization is always a good thing. Let the user decide what their experience should be like within the parameters of, here we go. Here's your building tools, and go ahead and go for it. It also gives nice incentives to move your team forward and get those badges and unlock things as you go, because who's not going to want to pimp out their arena and make their uniforms look sweet as they go along? And maybe that's secondary to some people for gameplay, but I think it is kind of a nice little thing. And instead of just logging as many games possible and kind of going through the grind, and obviously people are going to want to do that and climb leaderboards and climb rankings in EASHL, but aside from that, you know, what else are you getting in the experience? What are you gaining? And now you're gaining more and more options as far as taking your look to the next level. And also, they talked about here, I guess I haven't touched on, there are some new face types and some new customization going into your player. So that's the first thing you're going to see when you jump into the mode. Obviously, he's going to be used for the Be a Pro as well, or whatever they're going to call it this year. Still waiting on information on that, by the way. I'm hoping that a trailer drops on that, and I'm hoping that we find out there's new depth to the Be a Pro or career mode, whatever it's going to be called this time around. They hinted at that they're going to kind of move some of the presentation towards special times in a person's career, you know, first goals and those kind of things. So I'm hoping that there is a lot to announce in that way. And so obviously creating your player is also going to carry him into EASHL unless they have it somehow differentiated this year. But I think in the past it's been one player that essentially finds its way into both modes. So I guess with this news, it's probably time to start thinking about what kind of a player exactly I'm going to be to contribute to my EASHL squad. I usually go for a winger, sometimes a center. I don't really trust myself that well on defense. I don't know if people want me back there on the blue line messing things up on rushes from the opposing team. I'm just saying, I'm pretty brutal back there sometimes, so probably best off being a wing, being a forward down there that isn't afraid to get dirty and create screens. And I think with the new net battles, that might be kind of fun to be that player that grinds it out in front of the net and gets the ugly goals and contributes to the team that way. I think that's probably my best way to play things, because I'm not a dangler. I am not a goal scorer in the way that I create offense for myself usually in this. So any way that I can help out a squad. But I think it's going to be a lot of fun, like I said, to create our own EASHL team yet again this year and actually follow through with it in the way of live streams. Is that something that interests you guys to either play along or to be watching? Hopefully the answer is yes. You can let me know in the comment section below how you feel about opening up once again an EASHL squad and then going ahead and making that a very viable and hopefully frequent live streaming source on the channel. I often find myself really upset that I don't cover enough NHL, and it's because, I don't know, I just feel like I get into the Be a Pro and it's been a little bit of a letdown. The Be a GM's been a little bit of a letdown. Hopefully all those things are going to be built up this year with extra options, and it's going to be more fun to do series on those modes. It's just kind of been a start up and fizzle out thing in the last couple of years and these first 2 years on the next gen systems. So looks like we're obviously getting more and more put back into the game that, you know, some would argue should have never left, but they had to do their port and get up graphic wise and all that to the next gen and then bring the modes over and build from there. So now that EASHL is not only back in the game but is thriving as far as getting new content, what do you guys think? Are you excited to jump into the league? What is your player style going to be? I guess you can consider this video doubling as my early recruiting. If you guys want to be a part of that EASHL squad and you got some skills and you want to be featured on YouTube, think about it, because I don't think you can pick more than one team unless things have changed. But you want to be featured on some YouTube live streams, just saying, you might want to bring your talents to Team SGU come NHL 17 release time and once we start up our squad. So I'm very much looking forward to your comments on this, what you think stood out in this trailer, what you're most excited about regarding EASHL play this year in NHL 17, and also your thoughts about our team starting up and whether or not you want to participate. It's never too early to start thinking about it. We could get out there and have a lot of fun. So there's yet another look into NHL 17 and its progress. Leave a like, and we'll see you next time.
Thanks for watching videos here on SGU. Go ahead and subscribe on YouTube at Sports Gaming Universe. Follow me on Twitter at NotusFan for all the latest info. And go ahead and check out that official Facebook page as well. Looking for SGU merchandise? SportsGamingUniverse.Spreadshirt.com's a place.